Stephanie says, I hooked up with a guy a few years ago, started getting it on within minutes. He's literally screaming and moaning.
What?
And I'm like, I'm all for being vocal, but I'm like, dude, I wasn't even that into it yet. And to top it all off, he hit me with an, I think I love you.
Oh.
And I only knew him for the night. Total cringe. Yeah, you don't break that out.
Yeah, that's how you get stabbed in the future.
Even if it's that good, you can't be like, no. I love you.
Yeah,
you gotta play it cool.
You gotta reserve yourself a little bit. They can't have all of you that first time. That's ridiculous.
We were getting it on, and we start going at it, and we're getting close, and she starts saying, oh my goodness, oh my goodness, oh my goodness, repeatedly, on purpose. Hard to finish the deal, but it was definitely a good time. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my goodness?
Goodness?
I don't think
golly.
That's...
Golly! Oh, golly!
Oh, gee willikers!
Oh, my goodness?
Oh, I'm so darn close right now. Oh,
I reckon.
Oh, Jesus, El Savior Christ.
Who says, oh, my goodness? Where is this?
I don't know. Did she give you a Werther's original after you were done?
Corniest thing my ex ever did was she told me that she could feel it in her stomach. I knew that she was lying.
Yeah, I've seen it.
Yeah, there's no way that is going all the way up there.
Yeah.
And this is a page from the Erik Woodworth book, I think, here. It says, I have given my wife a high five after every one of our sessions since the first one. The old high five. You may want to work that into the routine.
Honey, hey, get ready.
Good work.
Just tap it off.
That was good.
All right. That was good.
Brought your A game tonight. Little butt pack.
Throwing the heat.
410-338-1098. Corny lovers. Joe, did you weigh in on this? Speaks. Have you ever had a chorus? Joe Speaks. Corny lovers.
Speaks. Go ahead.
Corny lovers. No. My lovers have mostly been underwhelmed, and you know, say things like, "Is that all you have?"
Oh.
But I have uttered the stomach comment.
Oh, you have?
Yes.
You
yes,
can feel I it in your stomach.
Yeah, I feel it in my stomach. Even though it's impossible because there's a bone blocking it.
Oh.
You know what I mean?
Of course, that
right,
bone.
There's
right.
That bone. Can't go all the way.
I guess there's something.
With a vagina.
Here's another one. My hubby and I spank
obviously
each other's butts and say good game after we do the deed.
Ah, nice.
Wholesome.
Has anybody, is it creepy for someone to say, like, oh, daddy?
I don't like that.
I never
yeah
got into
I don't
the
like
daddy
that
thing. The daddy thing's corny to me as well.
I don't like it.
Yeah, that is
me
totally
too
corny.
I don't like it.
Yeah, I don't like it.
Oh, daddy. Oh, daddy. Like, what? I'm not your daddy. What?
Poppy's
a little different.
As a father of two children.
Yeah, that's what I was wondering.
It's,
yeah.
It's not. It's
right
gross.
Yeah.
I don't. There's nothing that makes myself snake into myself faster
than
hearing
that. What about, oh, mommy?
Well, that's on a different
Joe, what was yours?
No, I've had all of these problems. But no, it's mostly just the overacting.
It's the overacting.
And it's yeah just like, look, I'm not doing that much. Just calm down. The neighbors can hear you. I'm not, you know, Ron Jeremy.
Now, can I just ask a question? And this is very complimentary of the room. Is it possible you're all just being hard on yourself? Maybe you are performing very well, and your partner is really impressed.
No, but I think all of us. Yeah, there's a no. That's a no. No,
just
I mean, no, but we've all had enough sex that we know when it's real and we know when it's a put on.
Yeah, me
like,
too.
It's like you're sitting there, like when a girl is really feeling it, you're like, all right, this. You start to feel good about yourself, like, oh my god,
yeah.
I'm
because it's
I
available
it out
for both of you as you're doing it.
Everything's. It's always like a little mystery. It's like an escape room. You got to figure out how to do it, and when you start to do it, you figure it out. But then there's times where you're like, okay, no, I'm not even close. We're not.
No, no, no.
That?
We're miles apart right now.
Yeah.
And then you do the thing where like, that was really fun. Hey, I got to go. I got some smokes out in the car. You need one?
Well,
and then you drive away.
So, so what do you do then if you're with a creepy lover? Do you then not see them again, or do you just continue and hope it doesn't?
Immediate block and never acknowledge them again.
Maybe run it back a couple more times.
I find it if it's bad. Listen, and I've been out of the game for a long time.
Everybody deserves a second chance.
I've been booted many times. I have disappointed in ways you can only imagine, Scott.
True.